Hi, my name is Carl Brown. This is my capstone assignment. Start off with a little history. Over my life, I've done several things. One of the earliest things was driving a tank in the U.S. Army. I did that for a few years, but I served between the Kuwait War, Desert Storm, and Operation Iraqi Freedom, so I never served overseas. After that, I went and worked for a mechanic production company in Seattle called Talgo. They built the Amtrak trains that now run up and down the West Coast corridor. I was an interior assembly mechanic. I was a specialist in stuff like the seats, all the paneling, luggage compartments, the pneumatic doors. And I did that for a few years. In that job, I was elected by my coworkers to serve on the employee board. We reported to the board of directors for the company, and we also wrote the employee manual, the safety manual, and conducted meetings weekly. And at the end of that project was the same time that Todd Shipyard finished with the ferries, Boeing had done layoffs. There were over 1,500 people on the layoff list at the Machinist Union. So I went down the street, talked to a guy building the house, and spent another 9 years working construction. Mostly what we did was build high-end custom homes. I was a carpenter. That's one we actually did on Bainbridge. And within a year, I went from apprentice to journeyman. By the end of my second year, I had my own crew running projects. And by the end, I was running whole projects, like stuff like that. And then I spent my entire life working with my hands, building, mechanic, everything like that. While working on a construction job, I basically stepped off the third floor, fell 22 feet. My partner said it looks like I was doing a dive into a pool. Landed on my arms head first. 11 surgeries, 9 years, over 1,000 hours of physical therapy, a 30-day stay at Rehab Institute of Washington in Seattle, which is medical rehab. Elle and I decided, they call it MMI, Maximum Medical Improvement. You're the best you're going to get. So they sent me to retrain. The career I chose is paralegal, and starting next quarter I'll be going to Edmonds for their paralegal program. My vocational counselor said that it's been over 25 years since I've been in a classroom. They recommended taking a college skills course, so I took this course. Early on in the quarter, we were asked to put a picture on the cover of our folder. That's my boys when they were little. We were asked to pick three things. And the first one I did is the topics we enjoy. And mine was self-assessment, the ability to look at all my strengths, all of my weaknesses, and then work on ways to manage those weaknesses. The 64-question assessment done at multiple times through the quarter was really good at that and actually showed some pretty surprising results at the end of the quarter. But a lot of it A lot of it stayed the same. And then we had the Wellcast Day Planner. And that was one of the projects we had that was pretty good. I enjoyed trying to figure out how to schedule school time. I'm used to managing a job site and controlling all these different crews, but when it came to a classroom, I had no idea how long certain assignments would take, and managing home life, and it was just getting all that organized. And the next thing I enjoyed was learning how to take classroom notes. Like I said, it's been 25 years since I've sat in a classroom. I'm just sketching down random things to learning Cornell style, outline, the slides. And then I have issues with my ability to do a lot of handwriting. So Marwan worked with me and kind of set up and found different ways that I can do notes with my limited handwriting styles. I've been assigned a note taker by Access Services, but I've actually not used that because everyone takes notes different. They put different emphasis on different subjects. And I realized I need to take my own notes. I can't rely on someone else to do that for me. The third thing was learning all the different programs and services. Being a new student coming here, I had no idea what the college had to offer. And it's stuff like the tutoring, the math lab, the computer lab, and the library and all those services. I had no idea that they were there before. And now, having learned those, I know where to go for help with certain topics. And then there's also the counseling and academic part, with the advisors, the counseling, the career counseling. I don't really use those because I'm working with a L&I vocational counselor who's assigned to me, and they're doing a lot of that directly with me on a weekly basis, managing the plan, the program, everything. And then there's paying for school. How do I pay for it? With the financial aid stuff, the scholarships, FAFSA, washboard, and those things. And as I'm starting to have problems with my L&I, I'm realizing those might become very important. I might end up having to do this on my own. Just bail on L&I. Then we had to discuss, I chose to discuss three struggles I had during the quarter. And it's the main one I had was outside influences, having to take my kids to doctors. My son got his wisdom teeth extracted, but then ended up getting an abscess the next week. So I ended up at the hospital with him, missed a day. And then my computer, I made the mistake of downloading a new printer driver from a third-party site. By the time it completely crashed and I had it fixed, it had over 400 viruses on it. And they told me that they might have it for 3 days or 3 months. So I was stuck. I ended up buying another laptop as a backup. Then the day after I bought it, they called and said it's ready. And another problem I had is I told them my truck. Mechanically, it broke down, and the mechanic said it's going to cost far more to fix it than it's worth. So I ended up having to borrow a truck for a week from my father. And then I went out and bought a car. So now I have a car payment on top of all that, too. Another struggle is getting into school mentality. I've spent a lot of time just at home recovering, so it's, I go from doing nothing, coming into school. And one of the things I realized is that, like, every day of watching TV, just reading little things, is that I had a hard time reading long texts. So one of the things I did was went out and got some novels and just started reading to get my head comfortable with reading and just being able to stay on track. And then going from the job site where I was top of the list and used to being in charge and running everything and working with the architects, and I had two or three crews, and just have a complete understanding of what's going on, coming into class and being completely clueless. That's been a struggle. But it's nothing I haven't been able to overcome. And I'm also an introvert. And I struggle relating to people. I mean, just being up here is difficult. And then it's like, first day of class, I come in and I'm meeting a whole group of people I don't know. And I'm having to relate to them and get used to working with them. And that's a difficulty, but that's something that'll always be there. So it's just work through it, get past it, get to know people. Work through. And then on top of everything, I've also got to deal with my injury. I sleep an average 4 to 5 hours a night in bed. My shoulders will get me up. Depending on what time it is, I might go sit in the recliner and catch another hour or two, but it's pretty limited. Early on, they put me on a lot of painkillers, and I was on a heavy dose of painkillers for over a year, and I got off them. So I refused to use any form of narcotics for pain management, which there are bad days, and there's a lot of struggle. You've all probably seen me walking around the class like this, maybe once or twice, and I do that to unload the shoulder joint. And it's just something I deal with. But I refuse to take the narcotics. I actually did my neck fusion without narcotics or any, which was last year. They fused 3 vertebrae in my neck. They had me on the drip in the hospital, but after that it was just tramadol, which is like a high-powered ibuprofen. And I refused to take the narcotics. Just got past it. And then, it's part of my injury is I got a full fusion in my left wrist and a partial in my right. So stuff like typing is difficult. Handwriting is difficult. At home, I use the Dragon voice to text. So a lot of my papers, I just dictate right to the computer. There's stuff like the handwriting, which I struggle with. Tomorrow I have my communications final. That's a 3-hour final, 10 questions, essay questions, and they're handwritten, about 500 words each. I got to deal with that tomorrow and figure out how I'm going to do it with this hand. But I got to get past this. In real life, off the job, I have to do that. So if I fail here doing this, then I won't be able to do it at the job. So let's get past it. For the last section, I chose identifying 3 strengths that I possess and how this class either utilized or challenged these attributes. And I chose organization for the first time. My notebook, I got getting that all organized. It's pretty good. And Marwan, and we learned how to set up our notebooks. My challenge was I had one-inch binders. They all had the same picture on the front, and the only difference was the label on the spine. More than once, I brought the wrong notebook to class. Next quarter, I'm going to make them look different. Just a definite distinction between them. I've got adult ADHD. To cope with that over my life, I've learned I have to be organized. Everything has to have its place, or it just becomes a chaotic mess and just kind of falls apart. So this is where that strength comes from. Another thing I've strength was pre-existing computers. I've always been pretty good with computers. Not as good as my brother. He's a programmer over at Microsoft for the past 25 years. But I have a good grasp of the computer. I recognize a lot of the programs when I'm like in Word. This is the first time I've used the Word in years. But I recognize it and can work through it. This is actually the first time I've touched PowerPoint, but it's laid out very similar to the other programs like Word and Excel, so it's pretty easy to figure it out. And then we had the Canvas class early on, and I went to that and learned how to use the Canvas, and that helped because that was set up completely different than anything I was used to. It hasn't been too bad, other than just having a keyboard and everything. As I said, I got ADHD, and this was the big thing I discovered in my 64-question assessment. In the beginning of the quarter, I said, this is a weakness, this is a problem, this is something I have to fight. And at the end, I realized it was actually one of my strengths. Because with ADHD, you don't have just one train of thought, you have many. And I realized that doing homework and assignments, I could read a question, push it aside, read an assignment, push it aside. And those extra trains of thought, they'd work on those instead of off thinking about the TV show or whatever shiny over in the corner. Those extra trains of thought would process that. And it was allowed me to work on multiple levels. It was like extra multitasking. I mean, there were times it was like a eureka moment when I'd figure something out, and then all of a sudden I have to switch gears. But all in all, it was actually proved a good strength instead of a weakness. That's a quote I read a while ago. Different stages of my life I've gone through, from the different careers, two divorces. That quote always kind of stuck with me. That's it.
All right. Questions, comments, thoughts for Carl?
So, are you looking forward to your classes?
Looking forward to the classes, yeah.
Are you nervous?
Yeah. There's some. Worried about some of the limitations. Right now, I'm having problems with L&I. It's one thing they do is called a labor market study, where they go out, and in my case, it's talk to various law firms. And they say, can someone with this list of disabilities and restrictions function in your office? And I have to have so many say yes before L&I approves the training program. So far, none in Kitsap County have said yes. None in Snohomish County have said yes. My vocational counselor is sending it to King County and Pierce. But unless I get enough and say yes, there's a chance to just still kill the program.
Justin? Questions, comments?
Oh, no.
Do you have something? Janet?
What exactly is it that you're going to school for again?
Paralegal.
Paralegal.
I'm actually got enough credits between this course, which I'm doing on my own, and next course that I'm doing on my own, that I'll be able to double major when LNI kicks in. And I'll be doing paralegal and business technologies, office, law office management.
What exactly is paralegal?
Paralegal?
Yeah, paralegal.
They're assistant to an attorney, as a nurse would be to a doctor. A paralegal is the one that prepares the documents. They prepare a trial notebook. They do interviews. They review evidence. And they compile all of that in a preparation and hand it off to the attorney, who would then take it to court and present it.
Sounds like you would be good at politics.
Too introverted. I can't speak. This is hard enough right here. There's no way I can do it professionally.
So you mentioned the program and services you established, like what you mentioned, the access services for your, any other program or services or other things you thought you would have.
The library was good. I've used that a lot. And then the writing center, learning how to do the citations. And this is my first quarter, so one of my mistakes is not taking my comp 101. So I don't know how to, I didn't know how to do citations, properly format stuff. So working with the writing center a little bit helped me learn how to cite things. So, like my psychology, its final project was it turned out to be a 10-page APA format research paper. So learning all those really helped.
So before I follow on Zach, Justin, and Amy, my follow-up is kind of, again, based on Ian. And as far as the topics you're going, you did talk about the campus resources, but you're going to Edmond. And so how can you use what you learned from this experience, and not just the resources, but the course overall, as the next destination?
I know what to look for. It's my guess that they have similar programs. It's my hope that I can, now knowing what's out there, is to be able to locate these programs. It's like, I don't have a clue what's over there. But having an idea of what's here gives me an understanding of what probably or should be there. Yeah?
You said that you were reading books. What are they exactly?
Oh, just fantasy novels. In my divorce, I lost my place. And I ended up homeless, so I ended up living 4 months up in a cabin up on Lake Cushman. No power, no electricity, yeah, same thing. No running water, I'm completely off grid. My only entertainment was books. And it was going through the vocational process. I sat down one day, and I was struggling to read a novel. And I'm so used to thinking fast, keeping up with TV, that when you're reading a novel, you have to slow your thinking down to match your reading ability. And that's one thing I realized I was struggling with. So just kept reading books up there. We'd come down here to Kitsap County, go to Barnes & Noble, buy 3 or 4, and head back up.
Justin? I liked it. I don't really have any questions. You're pretty clear what you're saying.
I have ADHD as well. Do you have any advices you would give me since you had a long time?
With everyone, it's different. My son has it, and his is similar to mine. But when I try and tell him the various things I do, he struggles with it. And it's, for me, it's being organized. It's getting organized. It allows you to keep your thoughts from running all over the place. And everything has its place. And that dates back to when I was in construction. Because I'd be working on different projects. I'd end up leaving tools all over the job site. As I go over here, help this guy with this, and go over down here in this cutting table, my saws are down there. And at the end of the day, I couldn't figure out where my tools were. So my big toolbox, everything had an exact place where it had to be. So I could flip up the lid, and I knew exactly what I had in there, just by how it looked. And it's that level of organization. And there have been times it's almost obsessive to be that focused on stuff. But it's, I used to lose my keys every day. Just run around the house trying to find my keys, my wallet before leaving. I was always late to stuff. And then it was part of that organization. I'd walk in, keys go on the wall. Wallet goes in the basket, and I walk away. They have their exact place that they go.
It's awesome when you turn yours into a weapon.
Yeah, I like that.